In this exercise, we'll start with a blank Coresight display like this one, and we are going to transform it into an asset-powered display like this one, where we can switch between different assets that share the same element template, like these boilers here. And we're also going to create a second display that brings in two different types of elements. So here we have boilers and we have heaters, and we can have a display that allows us to switch between different heaters and between different boilers. To start off with, you'll need to have a Coresight server, so your instructor will know which one you'll go to, or you can use your one at home. Create a new display by clicking the New Display button in the top left. Then you'll navigate into your AF structure. If you have access to the example New Green database, that's what we'll be using in this video, but you can just use one from your own AF server, as long as the elements you're using have element templates underneath them. So we've navigated into the cracking process in Houston, and I'm just going to drag a boiler asset out. And when I drag out the whole asset, a whole table is generated, just like that. And that's only possible if you have an AF tree that that Coresight is looking at. I'll rename the display boiler display. And now that I have this table, I can just drag a few of these attributes out and create a nice trend. Yeah, well, look at that. All right. That's a lot of data, so I'm gonna shorten down the time a bit so we can make sense of what we're looking at. And you'll notice now over here on the left-hand side, this is new to Coresight, there is a related assets button. And that has detected all the other boilers. Since we made this display out of boilers, it's gone and detected all the other boilers in our AF tree that share that same template. And now if I click that swap asset icon, all the data on my display will change to the boiler that I just selected. And up here, all the boilers that I've recently worked with will appear in that list up top. If I drag out a boiler and add it to the table, now my table can show information for two different boilers. Okay, now I'm going to see how to build a display with two different types of elements. So I built one with boilers, now I'm going to build one with heaters as well. So I'll start off by just dragging a heater element out into the display and clicking value. So all the attributes associated with that heater will become a value on my display. Really easy. And then I'll just grab a boiler element from my left-hand pane, drag it out, and create a table. And all the attributes that have to do with boilers will appear in that table. And now you'll notice the related assets pane. Well, now it's detected all the boilers and all the heaters in my AF tree. See that? And when I hover over one, it'll highlight what elements on my display are associated with that template type, with a heater or a boiler. If I click on the swap asset button, the information on the display is switched out. I'm just going to clean up this table here and just eliminate a couple rows I'm not interested in. And I'll rename my display heater and boiler display. Now all this is possible with having an AF tree underneath it that Coresight is connected to. You can search for PI tags directly, but with an AF tree, any user can naturally navigate the tree and find information if they just understand what the process looks like. So now you see I have a heater display and a boiler display, and if I wanted to share this, I could just copy the URL and email it to a colleague.